Ya, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Pertama sekali, saya ucapkan terima kasih kepada pihak PKPA kerana memberi peluang kepada saya untuk berkongsi sedikit tentang e-learning, secara khususnya e-attendance, walaupun ramai lagi yang di luar sana yang lebih expert daripada saya. Tapi tak apa, just proceed. Saya yang penting apa perkongsian ini dapat sedikit manfaat untuk rakan-rakan semua. Okey, dan saya harap sepanjang satu jam ni internet okey dan semua clear, suara saya clear. Kalau ada masalah boleh angkat tangan dan tanyalah. Okey. Okey, berbalik kepada saya, boleh kongsi skrin ke ni? Nampak skrin kan? Okay, berbalik kepada topik pada hari ini, how to create e-attendance in LMS. Okay, apa dia e-attendance? Attendance basically kita nak record kehadiran. We want to record keberadaan, presentness secara elektronik. Okay, dan kita boleh faham e-attendance kalau kita tengok dia punya lawan dia, paper-based attendance macam kita print attendance sheet, kita bagi kepada pelajar dia sign. Itu paper-based attendance. Dan pada sesi ini, kita nak bincangkan e-attendance. Okay. So, bercakap tentang e-attendance, jangan lupa hari ini, hari pertama kita nak kena punch in menggunakan e-com. Dan itu adalah salah satu contoh e-attendance. Tapi kita nak bincangkan hari ini dalam LMS. Okey, apa dia LMS? LMS adalah Learning Management System. Okey, Learning Management System dalam konteks UMK, e-campus lah. Okay, e-campus. So, kat luar sana banyak banyak contoh lain untuk LMS, contoh Blackboard. Google Classroom also considered LMS. Moodle yang saya percaya yang paling famous dekat UA ni adalah Moodle. Dan actually Moodle adalah main engine kepada e-campus UMK sebenarnya. Jadi kalau universiti lain yang menggunakan LMS Moodle, so dia punya apa interface dia lebih kurang. Okay. Okay, sedar ataupun tidak, sebenarnya kita dah praktik e-attendance lama dah. Okay, dalam konteks lain, contohnya kita nak tamprin, kita nak record QR code, kita key in staff ID dalam event. Sebenarnya itu semua adalah e-attendance. Okay, so walau bagaimanapun, contoh-contoh yang saya berikan tadi, dia lebih mementingkan location base ataupun physical location. Okay, untuk learning management system, location is not important. Okay, location it's not important. Yang pentingnya kita perlu cari alternatif lain bagaimana kita nak replace physical location tu kepada sesuatu yang kita boleh appreciate supaya attendance tu meaningful. Okay, kita tak nak student log in kepada e-campus dan dia tinggal laptop dia, tengok movie dan sebagainya. So it's not meaningful. So kita perlu cari satu alternatif macam mana kita nak replace physical location tu ataupun physical appearance tu diganti dalam learning management system. So outline yang saya akan kongsikan sepanjang satu jam ini, saya akan kongsikan bagaimana nak record e-attendance dalam UMK portal. Yang saya percaya UMK portal adalah platform yang paling formal lah, paling formal untuk kita merekod e-attendance. Boleh dengar ke semua? Ya. Yeah. Yang seterusnya adalah saya akan membincangkan e-attendance menggunakan e-campus. Menggunakan e-campus. Kenapa saya nak bincangkan tentang e-campus? Kerana kita nak add sama-sama. As I mentioned earlier, meaningful activity so that the attendance is kita boleh anggap dia sesuatu yang meaningful, seperti nak buat satu aktiviti ataupun beberapa aktiviti, contohnya video lecture, kita nak advertisement and discussion, then and kita nak make sure.
Assalamualaikum, Engine Job. Can you present in English, please? Is it okay?
Sorry, present in English.
Yes, would you do it in English?
Okay, okay.
Okay, okay, thank you, bro.
You need to start all over again?
Start from, no, no, just start from.
Okay, I will repeat apa yang most important part, okay?
Okay, okay, thank you.
The outline that I will present here, I believe everyone is UMK staff, or do we have outsiders? Tak apa. Kalau if there is outsiders, I believe most university using Moodle. So I will present Moodle interface, and I believe that the interface of Moodle is the same, even though the template is different. Okay, but firstly, I will present the UMK version of e-attendance, which is in UMK portal. Okay. Secondly, I will present e-attendance in eCampus. eCampus is LMS for UMK that using Moodle open source. Okay, Moodle open source. And I will present briefly how to have e-attendance that capture the activity in the class. Okay, so not only capturing the login to the LMS, but also we want to make sure that students complete all the activity that we put in LMS. Okay, so I believe semua dah, everyone is clear about the outline. So firstly, UMK portal. So you can go to UMK portal or pihak PKPA, they have put FAQ page here. So if you want to go to FAQ, they have provided how to record or how e-attendance or e-hadir works in eCampus. Okay, so there's link for portal UMK here. So short guideline, you can log in to eCom ataupun you can log in to portal UMK and go to my course tab, timetable, and you need to click PTG or online button, okay? And you have also manual here. Okay, manual in form of slideshow here, okay? In case you miss what I will show shortly. So UMK portal, this is UMK portal. Portal, the URL is portal.umk.edu.my. So you can put your username. Username is your staff ID. And password is the same as eCom password, and type is staff. I need to explain this because this is the most formal e-attendance in UMK, okay? So once you log in, you will see the menu here, my course, okay, my course, and you need to select timetable, okay? You need to select timetable, and then you may go to your class list, okay, class list. You can open which class you want to open. For example, here, okay. And then the most important part is PTG/online should be on. Okay, PTG/online should be on. Okay, how it works actually, the CCI, they have do some what we call integration, okay, integration, in the sense that eCampus will connect with a UMK portal in a way that if the student log into eCampus and go to your class for about 30 minutes for one class physical session, then the portal will record that as hadir atau present, okay? And if the class, the duration of the class is 1 hour, so the student need to stay for at eCampus at least 1 hour, okay? That the technical part of how it works, the integration between UMK portal and eCampus. So I hope that's clear, okay? So basically you need to go to a portal on the PTG, and you need to make sure that a student log into the eCampus, go to your class, and you need to do something, okay? You need to do something to make sure that a student stay at eCampus at least 2 hours class, physical class, okay? And you have, if you have tutorial session, 1 hour physical class, so you need to make sure that students stay in eCampus for at least 30 minutes, okay? So the concept of e-hadir or e-attendance in UMK, they just record the duration, login duration, you know, login duration. So the problem is login duration is, you know, when the student go to log in, we log into eCampus, we don't know whether they just log in and leave the laptop and go watching TV. We don't know that, okay? Even though they're on the eCampus. So I will present to you some of alternative how we can make the e-attendance more meaningful. So meaningful meaning that we want to make sure that, okay, we want to make sure that students are doing everything that we have put in eCampus, okay? So for the second part of my presentation is more suitable for a synchronous session, meaning that it's not live session like Hangout, Google Meet and everything. So asynchronous meaning that you create your video, okay, you create video and you may upload to YouTube and or other platform, and you need to put to LMS, and also you may put other activities like assessment or simple discussion forum and etc. So that student meaning that we can make sure that student complete everything in the session. Okay, complete everything in the session. Okay. I will go to
eCampus. Mesti kau tak dengar pun apa tu ni. Suara dia.
Di mana? Okay.
Ya. Siapa tu suara dia tak dengar? Kau mama punya ni tak ni?
Tak dengar ke?
Hello, Dato' Aziza.
Orang lain dengar ke? So I need to make sure dengar everything dengar. Is
okay. Clear.
Okay. Okay, for second part, I will go to eCampus. Okay, we'll go to eCampus. So this is interface of eCampus in UMK. I believe that kalau if other university use Moodle, the interface is quite the same, okay? So eCampus, you may go to your class. For example, my class APT 2043, okay? So this is my class, and I hope the internet is cool, thanks. Okay. You may turn editing on. Okay, turn editing on. Okay, this is all the resources I put in my class. So I may go to the last part because I don't want to disrupt the activity. Okay, firstly, I will show you how to create e-attendance activity, e-attendance activity, because in eCampus, we have also e-attendance, okay? The attendance activity is teacher can create multiple session for this activity, and they can put present, absent, late, or excuse. So for one semester, I recommend only one attendance activity, because in this activity, you can put multiple session, you can put multiple class, okay, more than one class. Why only one activity? Because when you complete the semester,
thank you.
Okay. If you can follow me, you can follow me. Okay, you can open your browser. I think that's more practical, so you may remember what is happening. Okay, so this is first page, ataupun the setting page for attendance. You can put the attendance, for example, class attendance, ataupun tutorial attendance, lecture attendance. Okay?
Go back one step before, sebab tadi sangkut.
One step before, okay.
Okay.
I go back to the first page. Okay, first page. Okay, this is the first page. Okay, remember we turn editing on, and we may see the add activity resources here. Okay. After you click the add activity resources, you may choose activity. Attendance activity here, and you can click add. Okay. The most important part for this setting is the name of the attendance. You may leave the attendance name, or you can rename the name like class attendance as you wish. Okay. We will discuss activity completion after this, because we want to restrict the access of students. We want to make sure that student completes other activity before they can go to e-attendance, they can mark their attendance. Okay, so you can click save and return. Okay, you have class attendance added in this week. Okay. So after it has been successfully added, you can go back to your attendance class. So you can click class attendance. Go back to class attendance. So you may see the interface is quite different as compared to before. You may have several tabs here: session, add session, report, export, status set, temporary users dan sebagainya. So the first thing you want to know, you want to do is you want to edit the status set. Okay, whether you want to leave as default, the default is present, late, excuse, and absence. But I think the only part here is present and absence. So you may want to delete status that you don't need, like late. You may also delete excuse. Okay, and you also want to edit the point. So present will be 1 point and absent will be 0. Okay, why this is important? Because at the end of semester, maybe you want to print the report and you want to calculate the count of the present and the count of absent. Ya, ada masalah?
Ada dekat chat, ada pertanyaan dekat column chat. Dia tengok.
Column chat kat mana?
Ada kanan, sebelah kanan penjuru.
Okay. People chat. Salam Doktor, you can present English, okay. I try.
Hey, Dr. Anis, last sekali.
Okay, last sekali.
Yang last sekali Dr. Anis saja.
Okay, Lord, nak klikkan mana student set? Slow down please. Kat mana status set? Okay, status set. Bila kita klik balik, okay, for the second time, okay, we go back to class attendance. So this is the interface. Okay, we have several steps here. Session, accession, report, export, dan ada status set. Okay, you may click the status set, okay, and you may delete status set that you don't want. Okay, so my view is you just want to have present and absent, okay, and you edit the point 1 for present and 0 for absent. And I hope that's clear for status set. Then I will click updates. Okay, loading. Still loading. Okay, I think we have successfully update the status set. The second important thing is you may want to add the session. Session is your class. Okay, if you want to make class today, you need to create a session for today. Okay, but you may also create multiple session. For example, if you are in the beginning of a semester and you want to have a tutorial session, for example, or lecture session for every Monday, for example, you may click repeat the session and you can click Monday, repeat every week and repeat until you may put the end of the semester. Okay. And you may add. After you clicking add, then the session will be added for 14 weeks. Okay, but I won't show that for now. I will show the first one session at one time. For example, for 1st April time, you may put your time. For example, 8 a.m. to 10 p.m., 10 a.m. Or you may you may have from the beginning of day until at the end of the day, okay? But it depends for your preference. My preference, I always do this. For whole day, you can participate in the activity in eCampus. So they have the freedom when the student want to complete the activity, okay? For description, you may put first lecture, something like that. Second lecture, you may put the name of the class. Okay, you may put the name. Or if the session is tutorial, you may put tutorial session one, tutorial session two, and etc. Okay. After that, for student recording, okay. So this is very important. For student recording, you may want to allow student to record on attendance, meaning that after they have completed everything that you may put as requisite, so student need to go to the attendance activity and click the attendance themselves. Okay. We have automatic marking actually. Automatic marking, but I prefer disable it because the automatic marking, the way it works is the same like UMK portal works, meaning that if the student log into your class, the attendance will be marked automatically, okay, whether they are doing the work or not. So my preference, you disable the automatic marking. Also for student password, I don't think this is important, because we have put the later I will show you, we will put the restriction, okay, restriction. So our restriction for e-attendance is not the password, but completion of activity, as I mentioned before. Okay, so Ed, okay, still loading. Okay, that problem is because I tick the repeat session. Actually, I don't need to tick the repeat session, so I add again. Okay, one session was successfully generated. So this is first lecture. This is the time, this is the date. If you want to edit the setting, you can edit here. And if you want to remove, you can remove. Take attendance. You have the power actually to take yourself the attendance, okay? But we don't do this because we want students themselves take the attendance, okay? So tidak banyak kerja. Okay. Okay, done about creating attendance. Now I want to show you how we can create some activities and we put a condition for the activity to be completed. Meaning that we want to put the condition for the activity to be completed. Okay, for example, you may want to add video. Okay, video. So normally when I want to post video, I use page activity.
Hello, okay. Mr. Engine Joe. Before you start further,
Yes,
my question here is could we add activity attendance to our list because we don't have this activity listed in the activity list?
Can you repeat?
Yes. When we would like to add attendance as activity, it doesn't appear in the list of activities. Could we have some, or could we have any trick that we can add to the activities list, then we can add it later? Or you have it in your system like that?
Activity you can add later. Yes, you can add later. Actually, the activity you can the order is not important. You can add activity first. You can add attendance second as you wish.
Okay. My question is attendance.
Yes.
The attendance activity itself in our list, it doesn't That's why I cannot.
It doesn't appear.
Sorry.
It doesn't appear.
It doesn't appear. I think in our portal it doesn't appear. Okay, I got a message from our chatting here. It doesn't appear in UM online learning. So, thank you for your time. Okay, you can go further. Thank you, Mr. Edith. We are following you.
Okay. Can I proceed?
Yes, you can proceed, yes.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, so far we have created a class attendance using eCampus. Okay, so we have put all the settings. So now we want to create the activities that we want to student complete. For example, you want to add your lecture video. Okay, for creating video, I will not cover here because there's a lot of tutorial how to create video. Okay, you can create your video using Screencast, Omatic, or Zoom, something like that. And you may upload to any platform. I would recommend YouTube because YouTube is more stable, okay, in terms of streaming the video. So I will put video here, and the way I do that, I will choose page and I will add. I will go to page setting. So the name you need. This is compulsory field for creating a page. For example, lecture. Or video lecture. Here you may put the description if you want. Okay. And then the page content. The page content is compulsory. Okay. So I will put video in this page content. So you may go to YouTube. Still loading. Access. Okay, I will choose any video. Let's say COVID-19 news. Okay. So the way we do this, we want to get the embedded code, So the most important part is you may want to scroll down and share, and you click the embed and copy this code. Go back to your eCampus. You may click this button to expand. Okay, this button. And next button is the HTML button here. Okay. You may want to remove the existing content, and you may paste. Okay. You may paste the code. Okay. Next part is we want to put a condition for this activity to be complete. We do that by going to activity completion. Okay, activity completion. And for completion tracking, you may choose show activity as complete when condition are met. Okay, there's only condition here. So student must view this activity to complete it. Okay. Meaning that if the student don't open the video, the activity is not considered complete. I think that's all for important setting for video, page content, name, and okay, that's all. Save and return to course. Okay, so we have video lecture using page activity. So that's first activity. Let's say we want to add another activity, like we want to get student discuss about certain topic. Maybe when you want to Slack forum. Okay. So forum is a good platform to engage students to for them to discuss certain topic, or you may want to get them discuss about the video previously. For the setting part, okay, the required form is the forum name. So you may put the forum name. You may put discussion. For the description, you may put the topic that you want to student discuss. For example, please discuss COVID-19. Okay, please discuss the effect of COVID-19 on learning process. Okay.
Display.
Any questions so far? No? Okay, for forum type, if you want to
have
deeper discussion, yes.
Zul, kalau pelajar tu, kalau pelajar tu tengok video tu, kalau kita buka tu kata dah complete kan? Dia tengok video tu complete, sudden pelajar tu buka tapi tak habis. Is it consider complete ataupun dia tengok sekejap ke? Dalam kata dalam video tu dalam 10 minit. Dia kata dia tengok dalam seminit dia. Is it dia buka dia consider is complete ataupun dia kena tengok video tu sampai habis baru consider complete?
Once dia buka, dia consider complete even though it's not the video is not till the end.
Watch. Habis.
Okay. Tapi kita boleh kawal dengan menambah activity quiz for example. Okay, menambah activity quiz. So kita tanya tentang video tu lah. Okay, so kalau student nak jawab quiz tu, student tu kena watch the video. Okay, that's the only alternative. Kita tak ada satu cara nak paksa student watch sampai habis. There's no tool so far lah, at least. Okay, jelas Pak Mei?
Okay, kemah-mah.
Okay, boleh kita...
Saya nak tanya. Saya nak ada satu soalan.
Ya. Yeah.
Contoh tadi kita dah buat attendance, kemudian kita buat activity. Jadi bila dia buat activity tu, dia akan link ke attendance ataupun tidak?
Ya, yeah, kita buat restriction for completion, meaning that student can only take the attendance after they have completed the activities that we put that as condition. Okay, as condition. So saya akan tunjukkan sebentar lagi.
Okay.
Saya akan tunjukkan sebentar lagi. Boleh.
Terima kasih.
Okay, for forum, kat mana tadi? Kita dah letak forum name. Kita letak forum name dan kita letak dia punya topik dan kita letak dia punya forum type. Saya prefer single simple discussion. Okay, simple discussion sebab topik tu agak kecil. Dan menjawab soalan tadi, okay, kita nak bagi dia syarat forum ni, macam mana kita nak bagi dia complete, kita kena pergi dekat activity completion, okay, and completion tracking you may choose show activity as complete when condition are met, okay. So syarat dia banyak kat sini for forum. Satunya, the student must view the forum. He must view the forum. And then I don't think the grade is not. So you may leave the grade. Required post. Okay, required post. So you may put the condition here. Okay, the forum is only considered complete if the student post something. Okay, or you may want to post two posts. Or you disable this, you can require student to create one discussion and you require student to at least reply for one post. So you can choose whether must post or you restrict the creating discussion for one, or kita nak paksa dia reply kepada post. Okay. Boleh kat situ? Ini adalah, this is a list of condition, okay, that student should do to consider forum as complete. Okay. I think that's all for important setting for forum. The name, the topic, the forum type, and activity completion. Okay, don't forget for activity completion. So you can save and return to course. Okay, so at least we have two activity here.
Cik Zul.
Yeah.
Dekat activity completion tadi kan ada expect completed on.
Yes.
Yang tu kita boleh letak bila-bila ke kena sama yang untuk sehari tadi?
Expect completion on juga adalah satu option untuk kita letakkan syarat. Okay, boleh letak, tak ada masalah. Okay. Tapi saya tak letak sebab dalam attendance pun dah ada tarikh. Okay. So kalau dia nak masuk dalam attendance tu, so dia kena cepat-cepat buat forum. Okay. So dah ada tarikh, so tak perlu banyak-banyak tarikh lah. Okay. Tapi kena buat, tak ada masalah. No problem. Okay. So menjawab soalan tadi, so macam mana kita nak link between video lecture, discussion dan class attendance? Meaning that student cannot go to class attendance unless they have complete the video, they have complete they have completed the discussion. So you can go back to class attendance, okay, and edit setting. Okay, ni setting tadi. Dan pergi kepada restrict access. Okay, restrict access. Still loading. Okay. After you see this
John,
button,
John, you can John.
Yeah.
Again. John.
Again. Which part?
Before.
So I go back to week. Yeah. Okay, kat sini okay. Tu boleh mula kat sini.
Yes, okay. Yeah.
Okay. Carry on. Okay, our purpose is we want to link between video lecture and discussion so that student need to complete video lecture and discussion first before they can take the attendance. Okay. Okay, go to class attendance. Masuk je. Sorry, we need to go to setting. Kalau if you click that, dia akan masuk session. You need to go to edit setting. Okay, edit setting. Okay, we have drop down list here, edit. Okay, edit setting, and you choose edit setting.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Kalau terlepas juga page tadi, you can go to administration and edit setting. Kat sini pun ada. Okay. So go to restrict access. Macam tadi restrict access. After you see the button add restriction, click the button. Okay, we have several option to restrict the access guna date, grade dan sebagainya, but we want to focus on activity completion. Okay, activity completion, so click activity completion. Okay, so apa syarat yang perlu complete? Okay, we need to choose. Okay, for example, yang kita buat tadi lah, video lecture. Video lecture must be mark complete. Okay, must be mark complete. Okay, so video lecture tadi, the only condition is students must view the page. Okay, that's all. Okay. Yang kedua, okay, yang kedua adalah forum. Okay. So you may choose the forum we have created earlier. So the discussion forum, and must be marked complete. Okay. So for forum we have put condition student must post some opinion, some discussion, and also student must reply to other posts of student other students post. Okay, so boleh jelas kat situ. Kalau ada banyak lagi aktiviti, for example you nak buat quiz kan, simple quiz something to do about the video, so that we want to force student to watch the entire video, so create some quiz so that in order to answer the quiz they need to watch the video. Okay, sama juga create a quiz. Then the most important part is the activity completion. Should the condition is student must view dan student must have some grade. Okay, grade ni maksudnya dia kena jawab betul lah. Okay.
Assalamualaikum.
You may explain.
Encik Zul.
Ya. Yeah.
Yang condition semua yang kita setting ni, adakah pelajar dia boleh tengok syarat tersebut ataupun kita kena maklumkan?
Pelajar tahu syarat tu. Okay, pelajar tahu syarat tu.
So dia
tahu
akan appear, so dia akan appear dekat sistem ya?
Yeah, dia akan appear at the front.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, after you have added the restriction, saya rasa itu sahaja, boleh masuk, boleh save and return. So answering the question just now, so the student can view this this condition. So the class attendance is restricted, not available unless the activity video lecture is not complete and the activity discussion is not complete. So student know about this. Okay. So okay, kalau kita boleh view kalau kita boleh view student, maksudnya saya akan switch role kepada student. So macam mana student view sebenarnya? So saya akan login sebagai student. So bila login student, tak ada button lah, and turn edited on dan sebagainya. So this is student view. So bila student nak masuk class attendance, dia tak boleh masuk. Okay, dia tak boleh masuk unless they have fulfill the condition. For example, they need to watch the video. Watch the video, dia yang biasalah, play the video sebagainya. Okay, so try to go back. Try to go back. Loading. Okay. If you notice here, satu syarat dah tak ada dah. Maksudnya, the video lecture dah selesai lah. So kita ada satu lagi syarat, which is the discussion after they have the lecture. They need to discuss something. Okay. So the student will go to discussion forum. Okay. So they need to reply for this is the reply. Nak reply kepada post, saya tak pasti saya boleh reply diri sendiri dan dia consider complete atau tidak. This is reply for the post. Okay, I hope it will be considered as complete. Cepatnya 6. Okay, as you can see, syarat dah tak ada. So student boleh masuk ke class attendance. Okay, dan dia akan submit attendance. Okay, silakan, dia akan tick lah present. Okay, present and save change. So bagusnya aktiviti ni, so student boleh tahu they have successfully record the attendance. As compared to UMK portal, as far as I know, student have no idea whether they have completed the 30 minute or one hour session or not. But for e-attendance in e-campus, they can see the progress. They can see that they have successfully attended class. Okay, so they can feel that they have finished the class. Okay. So jelas ke semua? Ini adalah salah satu contoh method that you can use for, I would say, a synchronous session of e-learning. So kalau you nak guna hangout, mungkin mungkin you may want to depend on EMK portal sahaja. Okay, tapi untuk this arrangement, we can make sure that student are doing the job. Okay, meaning that they have no choice. They have no choice except to involve in all the activities, answer the quiz. To answer the quiz, then you need to watch the video dan sebagainya. Okay. So ada soalan?
Zul, I have a question. Zul?
Yes.
Okay. How actually are we going to start with the Google Hangout? How is the first step to invite student, and then when you create the NUA CJJWOKB ini, you invite through this link, right? meetgoogle.com. I mean, the first step to have address so student can link to our Google Hangout.
Google Hangout, panjang cerita sebenarnya. There's a long story for Google Hangout, but you may share the link. Bila, when you create a Google Hangout, I believe there's link, then you need to share the link to your student. Or you may post the link. The best way is to post the link in eCampus. Okay. Why post the link eCampus? Because we want to make sure that student log into the eCampus, barulah kita boleh capture the attendance. Okay. So, kalau nak guna hangout, so you need to make sure student stay in eCampus. Only then the e attendance will be captured by UMK portal. The main concept is you need to share the link. Okay, Google Hangout, you need to share the link. I think if you want to learn more about Google Hangout, saya pun tak biasa Google Hangout. You can watch another tutorial how to start Google Hangout. But the basic concept is you can share the link and
student. Yes. What about Facebook Live? We have created a closed Facebook group.
In my opinion, you can also use any platform as long as you put the link in eCampus.
Okay.
Put the link in eCampus. And pesan kepada student, stay in eCampus for at least 1 hour or 30 minutes for one physical session. Ada lagi ke soalan?
Yes, another question. For the e-attendance, right? Every lecture class, meaning every week, we have to add manually e-attendance. We have to create attendance for every lecture class, right?
You have two options. Okay, kalau at the beginning of semester, you can create multiple session. Okay, multiple session, dia ada setting dia setiap hari. Setiap hari Isnin, for example, and you need to set the ending dates, and the e-attendance we will create for you. We'll create the attendance for 14 weeks automatically. Okay, but if you don't want to have multiple session, you can create one by one. Okay, one by one. Okay, is that answering the question?
I did that, but in every week lecture, it only appear for my next Monday class. The next after Monday, I don't see it appear. I mean, in the next week lecture class, it's not appear in the apa tu? In the eCampus.
Okay,
every lecture class tu, you have to add manually. Memanglah dalam you punya tu kita dah buat multiple, tetapi dalam screen in the weekly, it does not appear. It only appear on the week yang I do today.
Okay, for if you want to go to the report view, sebenarnya kalau kita nak bagi semua tu ada dalam list ni, sebenarnya kita kena click all button here, baru dia keluar semua. Sebab dia akan hide, kadang-kadang dia hide the previous session. So we need to unhide the previous session, like clicking the all or all pass. For mask, kalau you click day, dia akan keluar hari itu je lah. Dia akan keluar dalam screening untuk hari itu sahaja. Okay? Boleh ke, bro?
Lagi sekali, klik kat mana? All pass?
can you see the screen? Kita ada session, right? Tab session here. And below the tab, we have option all past, months, week, day. Okay, if you want to list everything, you need to click all or all past. All can be the future class. Okay, all past the all previous class. Does it solve your problem? If you can see the report here, so at the end of semester, you can have the report of student clicking the attendance, and you may print the report, boleh masuk dalam course file. I think it's quite valid for course file, for recording or as evidence as attendance in class. Okay. So ada soalan lain sebelum kita, saya rasa dah lebih dah pukul 11 ni. Yes, okay.
Zul, untuk soalan Prof Suzana tu, yeah. Saya rasa apa yang Prof ingin tanya berkaitan dengan appearance dia, kewujudan attendance tu pada minggu tersebut. Jadi boleh kita hide ataupun kita paparkan. Jadi untuk nak hide tu, saya rasa just klik ke edit button tu, and then kita just hide untuk, walaupun kita dah buat multiple attendance tu untuk every week tu. Kalau
betul.
Kan, cuba Zul buka balik dia punya apa ni, interface di paparan dalam e-campus tu.
Okay, kalau kalau nak hide, turn editing on lah, okay.
Yes, editing on. So kita just,
kalau nak hide, just ni lah, kita edit. Edit and you can hide.
Yeah. Saya itu yang Prof sudah nak masukkan. Betul, Prof.
Okay.
I've been trying to, while Zul is explaining, I did that. So it only appear in the week of 6 April lah, next week. And I did multiple. I click multiple benda tu. Tapi yang keluar hanya dekat paparan screen utama ni, yang keluar only next week saja. So that's why
kalau click all tu keluar
manually every week ke, walaupun dalam tu kita dah klik multiple. Dalam report kita memang ada nampak multiple dah semua lecture class, tapi dalam weekly classes
sama je kalau klik manual multiple ke one session ke sama je.
Then it's okay lah. Sebab student pun tahu dah, pernah maklum kan. Right, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay, macam mana Ustaz Wei?
Okay, Cik Waridwan ada tu? Cik Waridwan mungkin ada nak simpul, nak gulung.
Kita ada ni ke Google Hangout punya step by step? At least sampai to the point we can have a link and blast the student. I think this is very effective because I can see 72 of us now online. Well, it's good, it's clear, right? I ni dari Seremban pun, I think everything is like, I'm happy to see this.
Prof?
Bolehlah siapa-siapa kat situ. Wan, boleh buat SOP untuk ni Google Hangout step by step.
Okay, saya sambil akan sediakan. Cuma apa yang kami buat ni, yang sharing session, kita ada buat rakaman, kita buat recording ni. Kami akan gantungkan atau gantungkan recording ni dan kita hantar email lah kepada semua.
Good, very good one.
Apa lagi?
Okay, Wan, saya tambah sikit Prof. Untuk menjawab tutorial bagaimana nak create Google Hangout Meet ni dah ada dalam FAQ eCampus yang mana available, dan tadi pun dah ada di-share oleh Prof. Surya dekat group post link FAQ eCampus. Dalam tu ada how to create Google Meet tutorial step by step. Thank you.
Alhamdulillah. Nanti I'll take a look. If I have problem, I text you lah, Wan. Zul?
Okay, baik. Ya. Yeah. Ada lagi yang nak tanya dengan Cik Zul sebelum saya wrap up session ni?
Tak ada kot.
Okay, ya, PKPA mengucapkan ribuan terima kasih kepada pembentang Cik Zul sekarang ni daripada FTV dan kepada semua yang telah join session ini. Jangan lupa esok pada pukul 10 hingga pukul 11, 12 ini ada session yang akan dikonduk oleh Dr. Tan Sri Guan berkenaan dengan AR, Augmented Reality in e-learning. Terima kasih semua kerana join dan Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Thank you.